Hello everybody, I'm going to be casting this 3v3 rated game. We've got MBL, Slam, TheViper, Dogao, Nikov, and Leary. So some of the best players in the game, duking it out. We're going to have a Teutons, Aztecs, and Koreans war. So first, let's introduce the Vipers team. Yellow, red, and blue. They're going to be on the bottom side. Playing as the flank is going to be Slam, playing as the Teutons. In the pocket position, we're going to have Tyrant the Viper playing as the Aztecs. And in the right flank, we're going to have MBL playing as the Koreans. On the right flank for Nikov's team, we're going to have Sai Dogao playing as the Aztecs. Nope. Sorry, I had to shoo my cat off my processor. It was really close to the power button. Anyway, back to professional mode. Nikov is playing as the Koreans in the pocket position. And on the left flank, Leary is going to play as the Teutons. So Teutons, Aztecs, Koreans, very interesting. Let's see if we see any laming. I know MBL is quite a lamer. Ooh, Dogao is sitting right on top of the boar of MBL. I wonder what he's waiting for. Maybe he's waiting for the villager to go for it. Here he goes. Going to take two hits. Boar's going to attack uphill, saving some health on his scout. MBL's lurking around, hasn't found the boar yet. The boar's right in over here. And otherwise, no laming going on. So let's see if Dogao can lure this boar. He's almost already to his base. Here comes MBL though. It's gonna be close. Here he comes. Wouldn't be surprised to see MBL take this boar. Here comes the village of Dogao! He's gonna go to try to block the boar. Is that the right decision, though? And looks like Dogao's going to get both boars.
Yes.
I don't want to say a poor decision, but what a mistake. What a mistake for MBL not attacking the boar. And now MBL's going to be left with zero boars as Koreans. He is going to steal two sheep, though, so good for him. Those two sheep really do help once you're down a boar. Nikov's asking whether he should forward. What is he playing as? He's playing as Koreans. Anyway, Dogao will be up a boar. It looks like the boar is running back. And nah, he's not gonna let it get away. Let's go over the civ matchups. Dogao's gonna be playing as the Aztecs, very strong flank. One of the reasons you don't pick Aztecs on the standard civs for Arabia is due to their ability to get the pocket position. Obviously, a pretty bad pocket. Don't get knights. But as the flank, it's a different story. They really take some of their 1v1 Arabia strengths and apply it to team game. So they're going to have the 5 militia drush. Plenty of food for that. And early amp eagles and some pretty good crossbow rating as well. Meanwhile, MBL is going to be playing as the Koreans, not the strongest civ on Arabia. They get their tower bonuses, but that's not really worth that much on a team game. Early game, otherwise they don't get any sort of bonuses, don't get bloodlines, no eco bonuses. They're only going to be strong maybe late imp, when they really hit their own with onagers, hand cannons, and war wagons. So on the right flank, Dogao is definitely going to have the advantage in civ. He also has the advantage, he has more food. So it's going to be a hard game for MBL, in my opinion. The Viper's playing as the Aztec pocket, though, and that's not something you like to have. Strength of the Aztec pocket is you can go early imp to eagle rating. A weakness of the Aztecs is you're pretty much useless in Castle Age, unless you want to do something crazy like a monk forward or an archer range forward. So not the strongest flank, strongest pocket. Slam is going to be playing as the flank Teutons. Much better as a pocket position because they have a good night rush, but they're going to be okay. Decent economy with their wood bonus on the farms. Looks like Slam is going to be going for... I can't tell what he's going for yet. Either men-at-arms or more likely archers or... No, a scout build, of course. Yeah, probably a scout build. But not a bad civ. In the flank position, you like to see him in the pocket, though. Doesn't that really matter because Teutons, Leary's going to be playing on the left side as well as the Teutons. And then just the pocket for Nikov, Koreans. Not a great pocket civ. They don't get bloodlines, don't get eco bonuses, don't get great cavalier. Definitely missing some upgrades. But they are a good late game civ. In fact, a great late game civ. So if they do get their castles up and their siege onagers out, which is more likely as a pocket, then they'll definitely be a force to be reckoned with later on. Anyway, MBL is up to the next age. Let's see, nobody's up yet. Slam and Leer are going to be the first up. They're going to be going for scout rushes. Scout rushes definitely favor the Teutons. The cheaper farms really help. And Leer's going to take some deer also, so that's going to help supplement his eco. Here's the stable. We're going to see Leer wall in through the front. This walls on the other side look a little bit harder to achieve, though. Maybe we can even wall in through here. And here. Leer's missing two of his sheep, by the way. So let's see how these civ matchups work it out. We only have a mirror war on the left side, so not too interesting. Dogao's going for his 5 militia drush. MBL is going for a very forward lumber camp. I wonder if he gets these walls up. If he doesn't get the walls up, it'll be a huge loss to him. And it goes to show you the Aztec dominance early game. And then just in the pocket position, will the Koreans be able to get to their late game or make use of their knights? Or the Aztecs go for some crazy strategy or make use of their early Imperial Age with eagles? Looks like the walls will get up. And that's going to help to nullify the Aztec Drush. Here comes the stable from Leary. Two villagers going up. Stable from Slam is already up, though. And Slam's going to wall also. Going to wall on top of the hill. Very good for him. Secure his gold. Although still vulnerable from archers here. We're not going to see archers in the Teutons, though, so not a big deal. And Slam has scouts out way earlier than Leary. What did he... I should have checked for a difference in... I thought they went up at the same time, huh? I must have missed something. Anyway, Drush looks like it will do some damage. Walls are going up. No, lumber line is safe. Berries are exposed, though. Any stone miners are still exposed. Ugh. Just barely getting the walls up. Very, very good play from MBL. Wonder why MBL is taking so much stone early on, though. Let's go to MBL's point of view. It's MBL. Perhaps for defensive towers. He's going with the barracks now. He's in feudal age. Doesn't have an archery range yet, so... Looks like he's just going for a tower defense. Meanwhile, scout fight on the right side. No kills yet. And it's 5 scouts to 3 scouts. I'm not sure why Slam is running away. Here he comes. He's going to try to defend the scouts. And he's going to lose a little bit of health on his scouts. Dogao's saying, I don't know what MBL is doing. I don't know what MBL is doing either. He's just defending with towers. And meanwhile, at Dogao's base, let's see how you can... Wanted to compare the amount of farms. They both have the equal amount of farms, so I would expect them to be up at similar times. In fact, Dogao's taking deer as well. But Dogao's going to go into archers, and he's going to have a mobile military. The Koreans player is going to go up on 2 stables. And because of that, I think that Viper might be in some trouble. I expect to see a mug defense from him. MBL will have his towers to defend from the knights. And Slam is fully walled. So let's see what these 2 stable knights can do. It's a heavy investment to go 2 stables early on. Especially with a civ that doesn't specialize in it. And let's see if they do any damage. A little bit of missed micro from Slam. Oh, that village just overchopped at the last second. Here comes the scouts. They're going to go straight in. Are they? Oh, no. Is it open? Okay, just closed off at the last second. Missed opportunity from Slam. He's going to take a villager, though. This is one thing you see pro players do. They like to have their scouts try to block the villager from getting to the town center. Looks like MBL has finally decided to make some sort of army. His golds are very exposed, though. Doesn't have a tower up on it yet, though. That's a big concern for him. And very risky, too. Here comes Leary's scouts. They could do a lot of damage to MBL. Oh, this could be a disaster for MBL, though. Going up with the blacksmith. Here's the tower. Here comes the eagle. Here comes the militias. And it looks like MBL's just narrowly going to get away with this. I'm so surprised. Scouts are on top of the wood. And Leary's going to get two villagers. Meanwhile, Slam is still looking for some villagers. He got one villager from Nikov. But he's getting pushed back by now. And there is no murder holes in Feudal Age. And because of that, looks like these four villagers are going to be doomed. The top side, the Viper's making some good use out of his eagle, taking a few archers with him. And one spearman should be enough to fend off these scouts. Smart play from MBL. Despite all of this, MBL is still stuck in the Feudal Age, while Dogao is into the Castle Age. Going up to the second town center, should be making crossbow shortly. And there's crossbow, with Bodkin Arrow. So Dogao's definitely in a better position than MBL. MBL's now having to invest a lot of food into skirmishers and spearmen. And had to invest a lot of resources into the towers, of course, early on. Chain Barding armor from Slam, plus 2 armor, wow. Where is Knights though? He's just got a few scouts. Going up with the second town center. And already has Bloodlines done. These are beefy Knights. Remember Tuden's conversion resistance bonus also. And I completely forgot about that. Means the Viper won't be able to defend with Monks, but he hasn't gotten hit by Nikov. Nikov is doing some good damage on MBL though, and MBL is completely off of gold. And MBL, he's completely stuck in the Feudal Age. Doesn't have access to gold, it's a little bit of food, but he's going to need access to gold in order to go up or market. Finally, here comes Nikov's knights, no armor upgrades, they can't sit under town centers. And a monk from the Viper. Remember, the Tuden's conversion resistance bonus is a team bonus, so it applies to the Korean Knights. Looks like Leary's gonna win a small battle. He's gonna have to retreat for now, though. And why is MBL taking gold? Perhaps it was a bit of a mistake for Nikov to go to the pocket, because maybe they could have held the gold. But either way, looks like MBL's going to get his tower up onto his gold and secure his gold. He'll have a market, he'll be able to click up to the next age. The question is it too late though? Dogao is on 3 town centers, fully walled, getting plenty of farms out, plenty of gold, plenty of wood. And already has crossbow done. So we know who's leading on the right side. Who's leading on the left side? Slam is 2,300 score. Leary is going to be at 2,400 score. Not a big difference between them. 44 vills for Slam. And 47 for Leary. Leary has double the military, however, at this point. While Slam is elected to go for monks. So just a slight difference. I don't think either player is really that far ahead. And then the only difference with the pockets, both of them have good booms going. Four town centers for Nikov. And three town centers from the Viper. Only difference with them is going to be the Civ matchup. And the Viper, he's going to hit his stride really shortly. He's going into Imperial Age, getting his barracks up. He's going to have Eagles flooding across the map. And I wonder if Korean Knights are going to be strong enough to defend this.
No.
Luckily, Leary is going into Knights. And Knights are a better counter to Eagles than, say, a Archer Civ would be on the flank. There's that conversion resistance bonus, only getting one archer when you normally get two. And he's going to get cleaned up relatively shortly by just a few eagles. Anyway, there's the Castle Age from MBL, Imperial Age from the Viper. The small raid by Dogao is good. Do whatever you can to help slow down the Aztec push. If you can weather the storm, then maybe late game the Koreans should be a stronger Civ. Chain barding armor for Leary. Scale armor for Nikov. He's going to go heavily into Knights. Here's a third stable from him. He needs to make some sort of army. And there's really no other alternative from him. MBL is going to go for his first aggression of the game. Five villagers forward. He's going to do a Castle Age guard tower rush. And this could have been affected maybe 20 minutes ago. Because Dogao's woods are all on the outside and very vulnerable. But at 30 minutes in the game, not exactly sure.
Yes.
But let's hold off judgment. Two wolves getting in the action. Woo!
Yes.
Looks like Leary has more knights in this general area. And again, just slowing down the Aztec player as much as possible. And these skirmishers are actually worth something. They could prevent some walls from going up. Dogao is very confined in space. Only palisade walls, no stone walls. He's going up to the Imperial Age himself. And he's going to get kicked off this wood as well. Leary's going to pull back for now. And was I wrong about MBL's strategy to trush at 30 minutes in the game? Looks like I was. Let's check out Dogao's resources. That's what really matters. Plenty of gold. So he's not hurting for gold at all. Not too much food, though. And certainly no wood. No wood to make a siege workshop or no wood to make barracks. So he's going to have to rely on his teammate Nikov. Let's see if Nikov and Leary can hold their own against the Eagle Flood from the Viper. Best thing to help stop Eagle Raiding is to wall yourself. Only house walls for Leary. Still helps. Stone walls coming up behind from Nikov. And my god, this guard tower with the extra range even reaches this gold. Looks like Leary and Nikov is going to clean up the skirmishers. Tower is still up, though, and it's even walled in. And Slam is going to the Imperial Age. Leary is going to the Imperial Age. Slam will be in the Imperial Age first. Horse collar from Dogao. Ugh, ugly. You know, at this stage of the game, getting horse collar could have saved you quite a bit of wood. And wood is the resource that Dogao is hurting for the most. Going up with even more farms, huh? Might need some more barracks. Too many eagles for Leary to deal with. He's getting... should get Cavalier shortly, and Cavalier do a lot better against Elite Eagles, obviously. So want to preserve your knights for now. as long as everybody's walled up. Dogash should double, maybe triple layer these walls, try to survive until Cavalier is done. And on the left side, still pretty similar between Slam and Leary. Nikov is staying in the Castle Age. There's not that much benefit to him going to the Imperial Age. He's missing one of the armors for the knights, one of the attacks as well. So he will be able to get Cavalier, but you know, how much is that worth? Probably better for him to stay in the Castle Age and make as many knights as possible. Elite Eagle is done for Dogao. He's significantly behind in attack upgrades, though. And Dogao's hurting for food now. And without wood, he won't be able to reseed any of his farms. He needs to take out both these towers or move out for another wood. It looks like he's trying to do that with these villagers. Look at the flood from the Viper. Damn. Ballistics and Imperial Age coming in from Nikov. With Imperial Age, he can afford maybe some hand cannons. Slam is going for some forward walls. The army of Leary is over on the right side. And so is the army of Slam. Cavalier now done for him. Where's the army from Leary? Still no Cavalier, though. Paladin for Slam. Who needs siege when you have this many eagles? And it's not looking too good for Nikov's team at the moment. It's the power of the Aztec pocket. All we need to see is just a little bit of siege, perhaps a castle, and that would be enough to finish off Dogao. Goes to show you how important a resource wood could be in the game, even at this late stage. Not able to make any farms, not able to have enough food. And the tower's even taking him off this gold as well. So I really do like this play from the towers from MBL. Here's the Paladin upgrade. I see no Paladin. Oh, wait. No, I don't see the Paladin upgrade from Leary. What's up, DJ Sapson? The Eagles are really trying to get in. The Viper's saying he doesn't need any siege, apparently. He's going to go forward with a castle. And we do see a few quick walls. Why just palisade walls, though? And no matter what Dogao can do, he can't seem to get out of his base. He's just got a few wood villagers on the top side. He needs gold now, and he needs plenty of food. And there's the Paladin upgrade for Slam. If Nikov's team can hold for quite a bit longer, then perhaps the Korean power can come into a play. Here's Garland Wars from the Viper. Nikov is going into War Wagon, so I don't see the hand cannons like I thought I would see. And finally, here's Paladin from Leary. They're going to want to defend until both the Elite upgrade and the Paladin upgrade comes in. And here's the Siege from MBL. MBL's going to want to try to finish off Dogao as fast as possible before Dogao can recover. Oh, it was a bad time to delete the walls! Oh no! Oh, it's gonna be... What? The Eagles went through the wall! Whatever. Okay, the wall is up. Whatever. And this gate is down, too. Bad time to create a gate. And once again, Dogao's gonna get the worst of it. Not much happening on the left side. Slam's trying to push just a little bit. This is a team game. There's a bottom team and a top team. Blue, yellow, and red are on one team. And green, purple, and teal are on the top team. You can see it by the scores. The three teams are always grouped together. Where is the elite upgrade for the War Wagons? I don't see it quite yet. And will these eagles be able to do any damage, or will they suicide themselves? There's Imperial HQ now done. Dogao is left now on 89 villagers. He's going to go down even to maybe 70 villagers shortly. And these two eagles are preventing, again, Dogao from moving out. Here comes the paladins from Leary to the rescue, though. It looks just like just about even numbers, though. And on the left side, here's the eagles from the Viper. They could do a lot of raiding. And Leary needs to make a lot of paladins right now to defend. Bringing his paladins back. Elite Jaguar Warrior for the Viper. Wow. That's an interesting upgrade. I suppose to counter the Eagles from and Pikemen from Dogao. Onager from Slam. The Tudans player. Tudans get some pretty good siege. Usually you want to see the Koreans get that role, though. A 9 attack is just so much, even able to do some damage against Eagle Warriors. Anyway, Dogao is still alive. He's not doing too well, though. He's like a sick old man that won't quit. He just needs to give up. So he's sitting at 100 pop. Eagle raid from the Viper has been cleaned up. And there's a critical thing happening in this game that wouldn't notice beforehand. It looks like MBL, Slam, and the Viper, they have three corners for trade in this game. They have the corner on the right, corner on the bottom, and then left corner, which has all been secured by some walls or map control. No, all secured by walls. So if this game goes on a little bit longer, then just through the trade, they should win this game. Dogao, Nikov, and Leary, their team will have to reclaim one of these corners to stay in this game. And I don't know which corner they're going to be pushing from. Definitely not going to be pushing from the right. And the left side, Slam has been pretty strong this whole game. He's even gone into Teutonic Knight. You're not going to push Teutonic Knight at all. The weakness of Teutonic Knight is, not being able to do enough damage because they're not mobile enough. But their weakness has never been not being able to push... The weakness has never been not of being a soft unit. We need to see the elite upgrade, though. And these aren't exactly halbs quite yet. So Paladin's still going to be reasonably good against them. There's the halb upgrade. But it's a little too late. The Viper's got elite Jag and two-handed swordsman with Garland Wars. And I think this game's going to be over shortly. I ask that every time, Starks. Why am I here? There's the GG. Too bad we didn't get to see a little more action from the Teutonic Knight and Jaguar Warrior, but pretty good game overall. Very unorthodox strat from MBL, going with tower defense. Dogao had the advantage early on, but that Imperial Age from the Viper. Viper wasn't hurt at all during the Castle Age from Nikov's Knight Raids. And that early imp was just so strong. Able to box Dogao in his base, basically nullify Dogao, and Nikov not able to do anything with his knights. Had to switch into War Wagon, but wasn't able to do the damage, and Slam was just a beast. quickly check the achievements. MVP of this game going to the Viper. 187 kills, 130 deaths. Great KD ratio for him. 17 buildings raised just with Eagle Warriors alone. Wow, look at this relic gold from Nikov. Good relic gold. Two relics for him. And you can see Viper's score really increased as he hits Imperial Age.